The title update 5 changes are now fully implemented, and amongst those changes were huge buffs to skill power and everything related to skills. It's Lieutenant Buzz Lightbeer, and I am back in familiar territory with the first of my Division 2 build guides, and I think that you are really going to like this one. I posted a teaser for this build on Twitter and received an impressive amount of interest in me producing and uploading the concept, as I like to think that I tend to stay on the fringes of the build meta, i.e. I stay outside the box when it comes to build concepts. And with that, let's jump straight into this build as I lay out piece by piece how to assemble and construct your very own assault-style deflector drone ballistic shield combo. The Division 2 is extremely punishing when it comes to gear, as in order to loot and assemble the proper build could take more hours than many of us have available to play. So with that being said, I will lay out the framework for this build, but understand that you do not have to have the exact gear that I show you on screen. I will also include in the comment section a detailed breakdown of all the different gear pieces that I would recommend you look to loot, so that you have some options when it comes to assembly of your build. First up is the mask, and for my build, I have equipped a Providence defense mask for the 10% skill power, along with health, skill power, and I recalibrated hard hitting onto this mask as well. Of all my gear drops, masks seem to come for me in two forms, bad and worse. I always loot the wrong mask with low attribute rolls, so if I had the chance to really pick and choose what I wanted, I would have tried for either skill haste or a 50% plus damage to elites roll in place of this low health roll, but alas, this is what I have to work with. Other solid options for your mask could be the Wyvern Wear Maxillam Respirator or the Sokolov Special Operations Mask if you were going for an SMG build concept. Whichever way you choose, try to loot one of these three masks with skill power, skill haste, damage to elites, and as the gear talent, hard hitting. Next up is the chest piece, and this may seem a bit odd, but I have elected to use a 5-1-1 tactical Taclite plate carrier with all weapon damage, skill power, and critical hit chance, along with Beserk as the gear talent. The 5-1-1 gear bonus for the one piece provides a small protection from elites bonus, and since I am using a shield that does not provide full body coverage, Beserk awards me extra damage once my player armor starts being depleted. So in theory, I want to take damage directly to my player in order to strip off a bit of the armor and boost my weapon damage. But there is a very fine line between taking a little damage and getting folded, and you will need to learn those limitations. Since skill haste is not available as an attribute on the chest piece, I would have preferred either a much higher critical hit chance roll, or if that was not available, a high bonus armor roll. Other possible chest piece selections could be the Providence body armor system, or the Yawl Glacier Bay vest with all weapon damage, skill power, and armor, along with hard hitting, hardened, insulated, or vital as the common gear talents. I chose Beserk to try and push this build to extremes, but it is not required. Mods are always important to your build, and in my case, since I am attempting to use Beserk, I need offensive mods to unlock it. My chest piece features two offensive mod slots, which I have equipped mods that give my build 3.5% all weapon damage and 6% assault rifle damage. For my holster, I have equipped the Wyvern Wear Didactyl Pad Holster with a decent skill power roll and hard hitting as the gear talent. Once again, this is not my ideal selection in terms of gear for this build, but it worked. Other solid holster options include the Douglas & Harding Awe Thigh Mag, Providence Modular Holster, and Wyvern Wear Talon Tactical Holster, all with skill haste and skill power attribute rolls. My holster featured another offensive mod slot for which I equipped a mod that grants me 1% weapon damage along with 4% assault rifle damage and 1% damage to armor. If masks are my most terrible gear piece loot drops, backpacks are a close second. Now for this build, I have chosen to equip the Alps Summit Armament Mountain Hiking Pack with skill power and skill haste as the attribute rolls, and I have recalibrated it to include hard hitting as the passive gear talent. By equipping two pieces of Alps Summit Armament gear, my agent receives 20% skill haste along with 5% skill power. My backpack also came equipped with Safeguard, and since I have too many offensive mods, will not unlock for this build. Such as RNG in the Division 2, right? I have equipped a utility mod with 405 shield skill power along with another offensive mod with 2.5% all weapon damage. Other solid backpack options would include the 511 All Hazards Nitro and Rush 24 backpacks, Gila Inventory System, Providence SW, RNK Dubon Fitted Hauler, and Wyvern Wear Scapula Bug Out backpacks. My gloves are Alps Summit armament that I have recalibrated to include assault rifle damage and feature clutch as the gear talent. Now, since I am using absolutely zero healing skills, clutch provides me just a little bit of healing while I am within critical strike range and face tanking NPCs. Now, although my critical hit chance is not very high, I just need to crit every so often to trigger the healing effects, and that 20% health restoration is way more important to me versus the measly 1% armor repair. My gloves featured a utility mod slot for which I have equipped a mod with plus 189 skill power. Other solid gloves options include the 511 Station Grip Gloves, Alps Climbing Gloves, Providence Tactical Assault Gloves, and Yall Shasta and Yall Olympic Gloves. Now make sure to recalibrate for assault rifle damage, and if you can find gloves with skill power as an attribute along with hard hitting or clutch as the gear talent, they will work just fine. And finally, we have made it to the knee pads, and I have chosen to equip the Naskied Knee Protectors from the Fenris Group AB Gear brand. My knee pads have skill power, and I have also chosen to recalibrate them to include hard hitting as the passive gear talent. Now, they also feature patience, but I cannot unlock it due to me not having enough defensive attributes. The one piece for the Fenris gear unlocks the additional 10% assault rifle damage, which is a no-brainer for any build concept. Always equip the correct gear to unlock those large weapon damage bonuses. Like if you decided to not use an assault rifle like me and instead wanted to use the MPX Chatterbox combo that I had originally intended to use, I would recommend to make sure to have at least one piece of Sokolov Concern gear equipped for the additional SMG damage. Other solid knee pad options could include either the China Light HX02 or the Providence Urban Warfare knee pads with Haste and Empowered as the passive gear talent if you need a little extra skill power. Hard hitting is also another solid option when it comes to your passive weapon talent. Once again, I will leave this entire breakdown of possible gear choices in the video description below for future reference, and please leave any questions for me concerning gear in the comment section. Okay, so moving on to the weaponry, and I decided to pair this build with the Eagle Bearer Assault Rifle. I mean, we have build guides all over YouTube showcasing 4 gazillion DPS with an Eagle Bearer, so I decided to turn the meta on its head and use one with my Crusader Shield build guide. The Eagle Bearer pairs nicely with this build, as the first and second weapon talents of Eagle Strike and Tenacity pair superbly, but be extremely careful with Tenacity, as it can fold you in half if you were on very low health and the buff expires, therefore stacking the taken damage while the buff was active onto your health pool all at once. If you were not proficient at riding that fine line between max damage with no armor and getting melted, you may want to swap out the Eagle Bearer for another assault rifle, or even my original pairing of the MPX and Chatterbox for a bit more protection. Now, since my build is all about the Eagle Bearer, choose any other secondary and side armor of your choosing, keeping in mind that those with holstered weapon talents will stack those onto the Eagle Bearer. Now, since my build is built solely around this exotic AR, double duty and overlap would be my ideal choices for holstered talents. Now onto the skills, and this isn't overly complicated, as we are pairing a Crusader Ballistic Shield with a Deflector Drone as our two skills. First up, the Crusader Shield allows the use of primary weaponry, excluding marksman rifles and LMGs, so you could really use anything you wanted, like a rifle, shotgun, SMG, or even a sidearm. Now, since the Crusader Shield is lightweight and not nearly as resilient as its bigger brother, the Bulwark Shield, we need to increase its toughness through health and active regeneration mods. My mods are not the highest or best, but I have equipped two health mods, one with 69.5%, the other with 98.8% health, along with a 56.6% active regen mod. The health mods increase my overall shield health, so it can absorb more incoming damage, while the active regeneration mod functions as a shield health repair mod while I am in combat and taking damage. The higher percent your regen mods, the faster your shield will return to full health. Keep in mind that shield damage mods do not affect your weapon damage when you equip them with the Crusader Shield, so do not equip these mods as they will be a wasted mod slot. In its present configuration and using my shield mods, my Crusader Shield has a total health of just over 678,000, has an active regen of 26.5k health points per second, and if totally destroyed, can be back off cooldown in 28.2 seconds. If I had more skill haste on my build or I had higher active regen mods, these numbers would change, but overall, it works pretty well. My second skill is the Defender Drone, and I have equipped what available mods I had for it, which included a health mod, the Sharpshooter Specialization skill haste mod, and a duration mod as well. None of these are near the best, but the skill haste mod is not bad and requires only that you equip the Sharpshooter Specialization. I use the Defender Drone when I get into a hectic multi-enemy engagement where I am being rapidly flanked and need the extra coverage. So overall, this build features an Eagle Bearer pushing out around 27k damage, a bit of crit and headshot damage, a total of 61% all weapon damage and AR damage, 40% damage to elites, which could be significantly more if I could loot a mask with 50% plus DTE, 190k armor and virtually no health, but hey, we're going for an assault style build, right? That means damage. I hope you enjoyed my first Division 2 build guide, and I look forward to reading your thoughts in the comments section below. If you could take the time to rate the video with a thumbs up if you liked it, or a thumbs down if you did not, it would be appreciated. Make sure to stay tuned to this video, as I will showcase some clips of me using this build in challenge difficulty missions so you can see what kind of damage and resiliency it can offer up players. If you haven't taken the time to pound that sub button, please do so, and make sure to click on the bell icon to receive notifications for all content I post to YouTube. Follow me on Twitter for all my latest posts, as I stay active in the Division discussions, and you can also find and follow me over on Twitch with weekly streams. Remember to stay tuned for those shield build clips. And until my next video, this is Lieutenant Buzz Lightbeer, signing off.
Getting that Black Tusk assault team out of there is your main objective. But there are a few high priority targets we want you to neutralize. Their codenames are Puck, Roadblock, and Carver.
Copy. On your lead.
You're gonna have to do this room by room. We have zero intel on how they're set up on site.
Electronic device detected.
is down. Good work. Continue clearing the building. Black Tusk specializes in dealing with situations like this, but the site is under our control. We need to prevent True Sons from using the Metro to transport chemical weapons. So start by disabling any operational trains you find.
You can't let those munitions be distributed. You saw what they did to the castle.